Welcome to the Forgotten Realms, apprentice. You must learn the ways of Bloodforge and battle if you are to amount to anything here. I will guide you through a training ground where you can practice the basics of leadership. You can also use the question mark cursor and encyclopedia to learn more about game features. Feel free to experiment, but don't attack the peasant or his home. We will need them later. You will begin this tutorial with a Bloodforge and two Basal Golems. The Basal Golems gather your spell power, which we locals call mana. You can select a golem, then transfer its store of mana to your Bloodforge. When you have at least 40 mana, you can select your Bloodforge and create more Basal Golems. Your first goal is to have 6 total golems under your control. Select the Victory Conditions button if you want me to repeat these instructions.
Insufficient mana.
You control 6 basal golems. You now have a strong power base to support your campaign. Your next order of business is to explore this region using your basal golems. To do this, move your golems into unexplored territory by selecting destinations in either the action window or on the level map. Eventually, you will discover that your progress is blocked by an aqueduct filled with water. I will add to this map a magical item which permits travel across water. We'll meet again when one of your followers picks up this item. One of your followers has picked up the drift disc. Any walking creature may cross over water if it is carrying the disc. Beyond the aqueduct, there should be a friendly temple. Move a basal golem next to the temple, then select its transform option. If you have at least 25 mana, then you can choose the cleric portrait to transform your golem into a cleric. You must create a cleric before you can move on to the next task.
Your cleric is ready.
You have created a cleric. This follower can heal most flesh and blood creatures. Somewhere in this region, there should be a peasant who has been assaulted by unruly warriors. He is wounded, and his home has been damaged in the attack. Your next goal is twofold. You must heal the peasant using your cleric, and you must find the item which will repair the damaged structure. I will now add the necessary item to the map. When the peasant is healed to full hit points and his home is repaired, then we can deal with the assailants.
that cannot be healed. That cannot be healed. That cannot be attacked.
You have created a cleric. This follower can heal most flesh and blood creatures. Somewhere in this region, there should be a peasant who has been assaulted by unruly warriors. He is wounded, and his home has been damaged in the attack. Your next goal is twofold. You must heal the peasant using your cleric, and you must find the item which will repair the damaged structure. I will now add the necessary item to the map. When the peasant is healed to full hit points and his home is repaired, then we can deal with the assailants. peasant and his home are saved. Now to deal with those nasty warriors. Your enemy is fortified behind the Great Wall in the northwest corner of the map. Flying creatures can pass over this wall, so you will need a mystical site which provides these. There should be an empty foundation near your blood forge where such a structure may be created. If there is already a mystical site there, then it will revert to a foundation when you destroy it. Fill all four spaces of an empty foundation with basal golems, then choose the transform option. Select the crypt portrait to transform your golems into a crypt. I'll tell you what comes next after you have created a crypt. You have created a crypt! Now, let's obtain flying creatures! Various achievements in the game provide you with experience, which is monitored in the upper right corner of your screen. This experience can be used to research new transformation options. You should have earned enough experience by now to research the gargoyle option. Select the Research button to activate the Research menu, then choose the Gargoyle option from the menu. This might take some time, but I'll be here when you finish.
Research completed.
You have researched gargoyles. Now, send your basal golems to your crypt and transform them into gargoyles, just like you did with the cleric. You should leave some followers in golem form to continue generating mana. When you have a few gargoyles, move them past the Great Wall and search out the enemy warriors. You will find that their leader controls a barracks, which he uses to create his warriors. Your enemy will be vanquished when his barracks is destroyed.
gargoyle is ready. Your gargoyle is ready. Your gargoyle is ready. Your followers are under attack. Enemy warrior has been killed. Your gargoyle has been killed. Enemy warrior has been killed. Your gargoyle has been killed. Your gargoyle has been killed. Gargoyle is ready. Your gargoyle is ready. Your gargoyle is ready. Gargoyle is ready. Gargoyle is ready. Your gargoyle is ready. Your gargoyle is ready. Your followers are under attack. Enemy warrior has been killed. Barracks has been destroyed. Your followers are under attack.
The enemy barracks is destroyed. You now possess the fundamental skills for becoming a great leader. You will do well to create basal golems and gather mana early. Explore the map when possible and collect magic items before your enemy can obtain them. Transform your basal golems into higher level creatures, which support your overall strategy. Create mystical sites and research transformation options to expand your capabilities. And use both items and spells where they are most needed. Fare thee well in the forthcoming conflicts, and remember the question mark cursor and encyclopedia. These hold the clues to the grandest of strategies.